When you sell something to someone, most of the time the selling is actually emotional. You are selling on mostly biases. You are selling with your words. You are selling with your psychological tricks and tips. So in this video, we are going to discuss some of the pricing tricks, how you can price your product. So user is going to think that this price looks more authentic and less than what I am going to pay on another website. So we are going to trick the user to buy thinking that this price is more valuable for him to purchase. So let's get started now. Now you already know a lot about charm pricing. Now the first step is that whenever you are going to use charm pricing, it is going to matter a lot, but you have to take care of one thing, which is it is going to work when you are going to step into a next digit, like 19.99 is going to step into $20, which is a big difference. So if you try to use it like $3.8 and use instead $3.79, it doesn't matter, because for the user they are almost in the same digit, $3 or $4. So make sure whenever you use it, you use it accurately, and you are going to use it just before the next digit is going to turn. So $19.99 to $20. Similarly, $50 can be $49.99. So this is charm pricing. Now the second trick is that you have to show your price into a smaller size. Our brains thinks relatively, they are going to think that this is smaller price. So whenever you look at pricing, don't try to use very bold, very big typefaces for them. People might not buy it because they think that this is a bit more pricing or they are charging more. So make sure you are using smaller font size and slim, not a thick font size for your pricing. So show your price in a small, relatively small font size. Now sizing is a relative concept in your brain. So even putting a comma in your pricing, for example, 1999, if you put a comma in there, user is going to think that it is a bigger price because horizontally it is going to occupy more space. So make sure you use a smaller font size along with removing the comma. So make sure you remove the comma so it looks a bit smaller. Another trick to lower your price is you are going to separate your shipping and handling fee from your price. So instead of writing $22 plus free shipping, you can use 19.99 plus 2.99 shipping. So you can see I am also trying to minimize the size of shipping cost. I am trying to show that it is very, very small. So in this way, user is going to think that I'm just paying $19 for this item. $2 is minimal shipping cost. If you try to put like $22 plus shipping, they might think that it is a lot. So make sure you separate your shipping and handling cost from your original price. Now, when it comes to purchasing, there are two types of customers. One are emotional, that are going to buy some emotionally, like maybe some medicine, maybe some other remedy, or maybe some service they really urgently need, or it is going to satisfy them emotionally. Maybe some antique, or maybe something they like to collect. The other ones are actually rational. For example, some computer component, maybe a hard disk, or maybe some memory module or something like that. So if you are purchasing something rationally, for example, your purchaser is a geek or that kind of customer, you can use a rational purchase, for example, 19.86. This is going to, you know, give them a satisfaction that this is the correct price. Now, if your customer is an emotional customer, you are going to write. Now, if your customer is an emotional one, you are going to write the exact price. For example, $19. Don't try to use 19.86 8.7, 19.5 or things like that. This is going to help them best. They really need this service. They are emotionally attached to this product, or it is filling their some emotional needs. So you can use this pricing. Now, this is all about emotional pricing, relative pricing, or showing price in smaller sizes. So user thinks that it is a smaller value. So that is all about these tricks. There are tons of tricks described on Nicolenda website. I am leaving the link in the notes. You can download the notes, course notes, and there will be further study links. You can use them and read more about pricing strategies and what are and other tricks that you can use along with these ones. So I hope you have learned something new. We will keep on learning. Till then, take care and bye.